Hello everyone, welcome back to Isaac. Brian's here. Say hello. No? He's just claiming ownership of everything he can see.
What do you want, huh? Come on. I'm trying to record. Make your mind up.
Cats. Okay. Last episode we did do successfully a challenge run. We have accidentally done a lot of cool stuff as Judas, but we haven't done Delerium. And I like Judas. So I think I'm going to give myself another sort of refresher course on how to play this damn game and try to beat Delerium as Judith. Oh shit. That was a great shot by Roth there. I honestly can't be sad. Yeah, let me take triple shot. Probably should have used my Book of Belial to get Roth down a little bit quicker. Try and get Roth to go down a little faster. Know what I mean? But I didn't, so... whatever. Let's pretend that one didn't happen. What do you want? It's cat though. Yeah, I was saying I'll play Judas as a sort of a refresher. Play Judas as a refresher course in how to play Isaac, because I've been having a bit of a shit time of it recently. As mentioned, several failures at Blue Baby, greedier mode runs, and a Maggie run that was a train wreck and failed to record. And then a successful April's Fool run, although it seems to be the case that we are required to die at least once on every run before we can actually make a successful episode out of it, so we're not allowed to have a win streak of more than one. Not that the run on the challenge was counting towards a win streak. See, I'm having to be super careful here because I've highly reduced my own rate of fire. In order to take triple shot, which is fine. Triple shot kind of makes up... oh, come on, brain, let's do this. Triple shot kind of makes up for the rate of fire reduction, but apparently my brain is incapable of actually dealing with the concept of having a rate of fire reduction and having to aim each individual shot and be careful with them rather than just throwing them out willy-nilly like you do when you have a high rate of fire. There is a bombable rock here, which could be good for us. Let's try to play more intelligently right now. And I need to get back on the horse. It's been a while since I played Isaac with any regularity. So, yeah, let's just try and remember how the enemies work. Remember about our positioning. It's fundamentals now. We've got, yes, excellent items to start off with, certainly will help. It's fundamentals. It's starting off with a easy basement. Serpent's Kiss, that sort of thing. I'm just getting through the first floor as Judas without dying miserably. Are you alright, Cat? I think it's alright. I'm going to keep exploring until I find a bomb, or at least in the hopes of finding a bomb, because we really want to get at that tinted rock if we can manage it. I also would like to find the secret room, which I'm fairly sure is right next to us over here, so we'll look forward to that. I don't think we can do anything in this room except spend a key for no reason. So, actually that also helps. So that basically pays for the tinted rock that I was looking to get. We haven't got a bomb, so we can't actually access what could be a significant number of consumables over there, which is a shame, but we can't win them all, and this has been a fine first floor. It's very difficult to have any complaints about Serpent's Kiss. What it is easy to complain about is a champion double monstro on a slender room like this, because two of these big shots could easily beat the crap out of us. Luckily we've taken one small shot, it's not been a problem, and luckily each monstro is in and of itself quite weak. And we do appreciate this, and the damage upgrade, and the fact that we get to go down to the next floor with no further ado. What are you doing? He's charging up and down the house now. It probably means he's going to want to go outside in a minute, but until he asks, he ain't getting. Our damage now raw is about as much as it was just now with Book of Belial active. So I'm expecting that with Book of Belial active, we're going to have an even better time with it. So this has turned out to be a good start. The Black Hearts have so far been incidental. So I'm not... Serpent's Kiss is an amazing item and is probably going to help us win the game just by producing these Black Hearts, which as Judas are very important. But we didn't rely on it in order to get this far on this run. Let's not refer back to the fact that I have taken This is my third run of this episode. It's fine. We don't need to draw attention to that. Even more damage is excellent as far as I'm concerned. And these coins are just ridiculous. What did I do to deserve them? I might check the shop out, but honestly, I don't think I... let's see if there's a bomb in it. There is a bomb in it. I'm going to say that's worth it, even though we could get restock. And I'm going to blow this up and hope for something like Tammy's head. Well, the matchstick, that's way more bombs, so that's actually kind of okay. It could give us something decent in the future. Provided that it pays out with enough bombs on this floor to make it actually happen. But, you know, there's going to be other things to explode. This is not the last floor of the game. It's quite nice having... Brilliant. Two basements to start us off here as well. I mean, when you're going to get back on the horse, I guess... I mean, I could have played a normal mode run to try and get remind myself how the game works, but I think the correct thing to do here is just to... You know... They do say you should get back on the horse, unless you have a fractured pelvis. But the reason you're supposed to get back on the horse is not because of... it's not like a walk it off sort of thing, but it's a... It is, but for your brain, I guess. You want to overcome the fear of falling back off the horse by getting immediately back on the horse. One time I fell off. I was doing parkouring, and I know, parkouring, a hipster. No. James, who does... Where are my bombs, by the way? James, who is doing videos on the channel now of Hollow Knight. Please check those out if you consider yourself even remotely interested. Was until quite recently, and I say that. It's possible that he is still doing the tutoring, but he has so far been a parkour trainer. I think I'm going to take both of these, even though it seems like a terrible idea, because I want the guppy item. So, him having been a friend of mine for such a long time, I have done some rudimentary but bona fide parkour. So, I was practicing on my own in a park, which is where you do it. In fact, a bona fide parkour park designed for the purpose. Stacked the jump, fell on my face like an idiot. Take restock. We get some very helpful items. And we go to the curse room, and then we leave. Stacked the jump, and then gave up. No, I didn't want to do it again. The worst thing is I stacked the jump because someone who I'd invited to come parkour with me was arriving. So I sort of... My brain went into, oh my god, are you showing off mode? And yeah, it hurt. I didn't get back on that horse. And now I understand why, because now I'm terrified of doing that thing. It was just a con over a wall that I was... I've been doing it all day, right? Until that chap turned up. My concentration went somewhere else, which is silly. Kind of... in a sense, because I shouldn't be concentrating to do those things. We're one-shotting these enemies, by the way, which is lovely. Shouldn't be actually using your concentrations. Should be very instinctual, if you can manage it, because the more you allow it to be instinct, the less you have to think about it when it actually comes to the time when you have to do the thing. In a running away scenario. Parkour, of course, being described as the martial art of running away. Which is true. It's not just true, it is true. Like, martial arts are... Well, I guess... The strictest definition is they are the arts of fighting. That's what martial means. Yeah, we'll do this. For some spiders. Thank you, spiders. We might as well use this. But the martial art of running away is basically the dedicated practice of moving in such a way that obstacles are no longer obstacles. Which, I mean, you can tell it's French. But as a result, in any scenario where you are likely to employ parkour in a non-exhibitionist sort of way... Wait, I thought we already had three ways. I'm very confused. You are going to want to use your parkour... Yeah, I think we take this, actually. We've not been doing too well on bombs as a result of that thing. And this can help us out on a blood bank, which is semi-likely to show up. Am I seeing a new synergy here? Just want to stop talking about parkour because it's boring the shit out of my entire audience. when that... Oh, that was terrible, terrible damage. When that enemy exploded and was poisoned, it looked like it had the effect of what I'm going to continue to call mucormycosis, because that's what Antibirth called it, even though Afterbirth Plus calls it contagion or something. You know, the poison explosion that infects other enemies. I'm fairly sure that because that bonfire was infected when it exploded, it had a poison class, poison gas cloud, or class, when it died. Which would be great if true. I am going to do this because I am the god of all Isaac. Now I have 7 cents, could buy us something from the shop. It could not, but it could, so there's that. I'm going to use this bomb here because just get out of my face, frankly. Semi-hoping for maybe a magic mush or just a pill out of the mushroom, but that's a very long shot. Really, you just want to get the mushroom destroyed so that you're not here literally your whole life. That's red. Yep. I do have a little bit of trouble still telling the difference between red hearts and black hearts. So you'll have to forgive me if I poke a heart to see if it moves away from me or not. I'm assuming that the lover's card will continue to give me red hearts, so I'm not too worried about that. And we have 7 cents, which means that we could get an arcade on the next floor, even if we don't spend it on this floor. Yeah, we'll take the XP, which will actually help with said arcade. So I'm not going to go to the shop. I don't really care. Good floor, actually. I'm not quite sure how fast we're going. I feel like we're not going fast enough if we want to do boss rush, which I'm not entirely sure that I do. So yeah, get back on the horse. That's the end of the game. Like in my Doom series, I tried to record an episode and stream it at the same time, and it all went horribly wrong. I just didn't want to re-record it. It seemed like a massive amount of effort that I wasn't down with spending. It wasn't a psychological piece of damage that was stopping me doing it, but I guess in the sense it was. It didn't physically hurt me to have made that mistake, but it was still a mistake I didn't want to repeat. And I didn't want to redo the level that I did on the episode so soon. It didn't seem entertaining to do so, and of course, having literally just recorded it. Hello, Brian. You're scaring the shit out of me with your shadow. You dick. Ooh. That's nice. So this would be Bookworm. We don't need either of these. But, I mean, I didn't want to... No, thank you. Replay the episode, because I'd just done it. You know, who wants to do that? And it took me a lot of time before I got back on the saddle of wanting to play that game. But if I'd just done it straight away, or at least the next day, it would have been probably a lot more easy to actually do that. Strange what sort of psychological knocks cause you to sort of not want to recover. It throws you for a wobbly, right? It's not like it's the end of the world. It's not like you've it's not like someone's died. Can I not go through this? Oh, I can. Not really bothered by that. The reason I didn't take the obvious book, which is the Satanic Bible, is that we're getting so many red hearts from just the items that we've got. Not red hearts, black hearts from the Serpent's Kiss, not even the virus. That we don't need to be able to produce them on our own. So we might as well have this thing that increases our damage in any situation where our actual damage is not enough. Which are not very many situations right now, because our actual damage is amazing, but whenever we're fighting a boss or maybe boss rush, we're going to be glad to have it. That feels like the secret room to me, so we'll check this one more edge of it. See if that denies it. It does not deny it, so that's probably the secret room down there. He says as though the secret room is a grand prize to be won. Not really. It is not, and I am surprised. Fighting greed here, that's okay. We do have restock, so I would like some real shops. But greed is not the difficultest... Yeah, it is. Apparently the difficultest boss in the world. Who knew? Tickle me surprised. Also, I would like to have bought my key back, but never mind. No arcade so far. It doesn't look like we're going to be getting one. That's a shame. Health up. Very well. We will spend this on the devil, which we're fairly likely to get as a result of carrying the Book of Belial. Today's episode is getting back on horses. So this is us getting back on the Isaac horse, which is the whole point of that thing. And we can't be too upset that it took us two false starts on this episode to do so, you know? I was never that good at the game in the first place, and I'm only doing this out of some... I like playing the game, and I like talking about it and recording it while I do it, basically. Is this the one that occasionally just does a tooth shot? I don't really need the damage upgrade if that's the case. So, I'm just going to leave that where it is. Because look how fast we did this room. And this room is a bastard, usually. On the Maggie run that failed, I got stuck in this room for ages because I couldn't actually reach the producer of the enemies, the enemy spawner. But on this run, that was a terrible, terrible piece of damage. And should not be mentioned again. I find it really difficult to dodge these enemies that charge you, and I don't know why. My brain will continually refuse to comprehend the direction I wish it to go. I think we definitely take both of these, because we can afford them. You know, Serpent's Kiss. It was Serpent's Kiss. I was thinking, wait a minute, it's Serpent's the Virus. No, it is Serpent's Kiss. But we'll keep the Book of Belial, because we have no real need for Guppy's Paw either. But... it's the second Guppy item, so we're well on the way to all three. Guppy? Could have been great. You let me down, red chests. Take these. So you can be... definitely want to practice our orbital game, because it's going to turn out to be extremely useful at some point in the future. And I couldn't help but notice, not to complain about this run, because our damage is great, but it's got that sort of Eve's Mascara problem going on, and I apologize if you heard me bash the microphone just now. It's got that Eve's Mascara thing going on, where our rate of fire is poor, and our damage is great, so we have to keep actually successfully hitting. We do have 12 black hearts, which is a rare situation to be in, especially on a hard run. But, you know, we start off as Judas, which gives us the advantage of being... very strong to begin with. Yeah, our orbital game definitely helps us beat enemies that otherwise are a pain in the ass to actually deal with because they are invincible from a certain direction. But it does run the risk of course, taking silly damage because you're walking into enemies instead of avoiding them. Let's get rid of these if you can get anything out of it. Probably not going to worry too much about looking for cards in there. We are on Necropolis 1. That died faster than I was expecting. To the extent that I was expecting it to die slowly and was looking at the map, and when I finished looking at the map, it was already dead. Luck down, not brilliant, but we're on zero luck now, which is still an okay amount as far as luck goes in this game anyway. I wonder if it affects the drop rate of the black hearts. It's terrible, but it happened. I'm not even gonna waste the time backtracking to get black hearts because we know more are going to drop in the future. Put butt bombs because they were there. Five more bombs does not help. Please, there we go. And the portals destroyed themselves, which is also very nice. I'm assuming that the secret room is over here somewhere. We could get some decent stuff out of secret rooms, so I'm not going to completely ignore the fact that they exist, but it's semi-rare that they contain anything of value. Like this, for example. Yeah, I was going to say, it probably contains a trinket. It always contains a damn trinket when you don't really want it. Back on the horse. I've ridden a horse once. It was okay. So we can get to the shop, which is probably super greed. Yep. Which means our final shop of the game is going to be a bona fide shop. Ooh. Hi. Kind of hoping for small rock, but not hugely hoping for small rock, so I'm okay with it. We should be on time for boss rush, so if we can find the teleport card that I wasn't really too bothered about looking for. Oh, it's the fucking bloat again, is it? Then I'd be happy to take it off your hands. We can just use this item to do all the damage. Brilliant. I mean, I've had a little bit more practice with the bloat as a result of the fact that it was every fucking boss fight on the April Fool Challenge, which you just watched, so don't give me that spoilers nonsense. Guppy? No go. Very well. Teleports. Speed up. Also fine. I wanted teleports so I didn't have to do this room, if you don't mind. Let's just use this lover's card. It's stressing me out keeping hold of it. If we pick this up, then we get to keep the... Oh, that's bad. Get to keep the black heart. Hopefully this Amic Cider pill will burn itself out on this room. It's already going fast, so we don't need to worry too much. And we're done. Okay. Keys do help. If we're going to try and do the hush fight, which we are, the keys are definitely going to help with that. Because we want to be able to open those chests and item rooms that are down there. We will continue to explode these tinted rocks on the off chance of getting the small rock. Honestly, Batwing could be a good idea right now. I don't know, actually. If we're going to be doing the Delerium fight, which is a very bullet-heli sort of fight, we might want to... I don't want to play it anymore. I want to keep Blind Rage, not for the Blood Bank, which we've dealt with. Like, we've denied. But on the Delerium fight, there's going to be a lot of bullets flying around. If we can take less damage as a result of being hit once and using Sack Dagger in the invincibility period that our trinket affords us, we actually stand a much better chance of beating said Delerium fight. And if we can get some tiers upgrades, or significant damage upgrades, Brian, sit still, then, you know, we're going to have less of an issue actually beating Delerium in the first place. Because one of the things you want... Just a minute. Excuse me. Cat, get down from there. It's not allowed on the sides. Especially not in the kitchen. It worked. One thing you can do is squirt them with water. They do not like that. But, you know, they know what kss means. So, a little slice of life there. This is the You and I sitcom where we yell at cats and play Isaac. Okay, no, I'm not going to do that. I mean, I might just do boss rush if we have to, but I'd rather get a card that means I don't have to. See, we get a bit of extra time on our damage, and that was the first piece of damage I've taken in some time as well. Here's our item room, so I feel like we've actually got lucky and found our item room on the way to the boss. That was also bad. Don't worry about it. I'm trying to go fast because I want to at least peak boss rush. This was not worth the effort. So I'm hoping the boss fight is up here and the shop's also on the way, which is kind of what I was hoping for. 7 cent mom's key is going to help on the Delerium fight for Shizzle. Logo bombs, sure. Trinket smelter actually helps. Fanny pack might help too. That will help. That will help. And that's everything. Full card, perfect. We have succeeded in doing what I wanted to do without actually intending to do what I wanted to do. Just spent all my money on a full card. We've got some decent stuff along the way, and if we find another trinket, we are now semi-immune to a lot of damage. Please, get out of my way. Which is also nice. More up? No. But I think we can beat Mommy this time simply as a result of the fact we have Sack Dagger. And we've poisoned her. Yeah, plenty of time. No worries. We've even got time to fight Krampus, which we're not going to have to do. More of the Void is great. It's not only HP, but it's a damage dealer too. Not HP directly, but... I think you have to say the Mulligan is probably the right thing to take here. Howl at the Moon. Let's look this up before we make any snap decisions. Where is my Chrome window? Here it is. Well, I've already uploaded the Doom episode. Go check that out. Of course, it's been up for ages by the time this goes up. Platinum God. That's the cadence of somebody who is typing and then Chrome has auto-filled it for them. Dog tooth. Scrolly, scrolly. Is it damage? Small damage and speed. Crawl space and secret rooms. Yeah, I don't really care about that. There's not enough damage or speed to make it worthwhile. Everything else... Oh, I don't really need to do that because we're leaving anyway. Everything else is kind of neither here nor there. These are all red hearts. So be it. We might as well finish this room. Oh, there's a curse room. And a small rock. Called it. It wasn't a small rock. Any other trinket would be fine right now, to be fair. I'm almost tempted to take the trinket smelter so we can keep them all. There's our luck upgrade, so we already made the right decision not taking the lucky foot. And there's some more spirit hearts up here from having exploded that. I mean, we could take the trinket smelter for the simple reason that the trinket smelter... Right, here's a trinket right now. It's more likely to do more for us, really. I mean... Do you think this... No, it doesn't. I was wondering if it caused the effect of... the damage dealing thing so that we could do it for free, basically. But it did not turn out that way. We do actually have more than enough black hearts to get us back to where we were. That is not the shop. I know it looked like the shop, but it wasn't the shop. Secret room here. Magic mush, please. I wouldn't mind a magic mush, not because of the damage for once, but for the tears upgrade. Puberty. Health up. Ah, I kind of don't want it. Look down. I'm going to keep the bat wing because we can't fly. And then if we smelt it... We can smelt them both, actually, but I'm not that much of a fan of Liberty Cap, being honest, and don't hate me, because I'm beautiful. So this could be one of those new items that has been added in the pack. Broken modem lag. Interesting. We'll take this and just smelt that trinket. We'll take the battery as well, sure. Does that recharge us? It does not. Okie dokie. Well, look down. I've got a look down pill because I'm too lazy to go back and get anything else. I don't really want a health upgrade pill because I'm happy with my permanent Polaroid invincibility crossed with random, like, the black heart damage. So let's go and just charge into things and see what happens. The mulligan will certainly help us here. Why is this in my life? Just like that, yep. We can get that and smelt the next trinket, which we don't have. I don't know when we get the weird wings. Maybe it's just when we get hit. What do you want? Brian wants out. Will you excuse me a moment? My actual accent. Oh. Where am I? I apologise that on a regular basis I'm complaining about my butt. But this chair. This chair. You'd never believe it. You expect a chair to be, you know, designed for being sat on? Not this bloody chair. It's not my butt. It's my coccyx. Okay. It's my coccyx. Yeah, we'll take that and smelt it. I think I already knew that that was a danger, and yet, here we are. Trying to till the end. Puberty. Take a second puberty pill, see if we get... We don't want the adult transformation, because we end up with, HP. Although we might want the HP for the deal with the devil, so... I guess we can take it. So, lag just means, apparently, that enemies and their bullets will, stop. Yep, which is fine with me. Try using... the, more do void here. I'm wondering if the lag item might actually be more trouble than it's worth sometimes. Because if you're expecting to dodge something, then it ain't there. That's going to be difficult. We've got rune bag. Rune bag is good. Don't let anyone tell you different. Right, we can't fly on the regular. Really need that. We'll smelt our lucky toe. So now we've got a permanent luck upgrade. Oh, I mean, we just picked up a luck uphill, basically. Are you a wizard? Algiers could be good. I think they nerfed Yera as well. In fact, let's be honest, we're not going to the chest, even if they haven't actually nerfed Yera, or if they've unnerfed it, because they don't actually hate us, even though it seems like they do. The Algiers rune is going to be a lot more useful. For example, the Can I get an Are You a Wizard pill? Read it out and then not even notice. Please. Must have done. It's worn off. Fine. Algiers will occasionally give us something. It won't occasionally give us anything. Let's organize thoughts, then speak. Hold music, please. Algiers will give us some value when we get to the hush fight, on top of the fact that we smelted the trinket that means that we don't have to worry about the damage that we're going to take quite as many times, basically. I wonder how often you get to fly with Batwing. Might as well take Endless Nameless and use that. It might give us our Algiers rune back when we do use it. Can't really tell. Tinted rocks, and I'm really not too... Oops, sorry, I bashed the microphone again. Too concerned with that. Looks like one. That was not one. All we can really expect from a tinted rock right now is... small rock, which would be nice. It's a decent damage upgrade. I still really would like some tears up. This is a point where I would not mind some HP, because there's a good chance that we have a deal with the devil. Terrible way to play the game, but it's working, so... Sure. Another trinket is fine with me. I really like the trinket smelter as an item on a run where you are getting a reasonable amount of trinkets. It looks like we're going to be on time for Hush, provided we don't get completely lost because of reasons. I wonder why sometimes my flying left me with no body. I mean, Batwings occasionally gives you flight because it occasionally grows you Batwings. So why this time? Bloodback would be good, actually, since we have permanent Polaroid invincibility. Could be worth a try. Might not be worth that much of a try, because we don't have too much HP. Could we fly in here, please? No. We will be getting some back, but not that much. Just give me the bloodback. I'd like to sell it to the devil, basically. I want to deal with the devil. Options that don't involve me hurting myself to a degree that I'm not happy with, i.e. spending 3 HP instead of 1. Pin is here. Pin lagged out, which is amazing. It's an excellent way to beat the shit out of Pin. We will go to the boss trap room and get Guppy. Possibly. Not come to pass. Another trinket, don't mind. Holding down the fire button is not the... key to more of the void. It is in fact simply firing at all, because if you are holding down the fire button but doing an I pick something up animation, it's not gonna do the thing that you want it to do. I love it when these enemies lag out. I'm really getting behind this lag thing. We've got an allergies rune, so I'm actually gonna go back. We have plenty of time. Key for the key gods. Can't fly. Forgot. Algae. So we'll allergies this. I'm gonna get another one. That's nice. Thanks to Endless Nameless, which we smelted some time ago. And we're just hoping for the blood bank, because we've got a good deal with the devil chance. And even failing that... Oh, and we have Tarot Cloth. So this is going to last twice as long. So not getting the blood bag is basically constrained by time right now. There it is. Brilliant. And we keep our Elder's Rune. And there's a chance that when we use our Elder's Rune, we get to get it back. So if we use it against the Hush fight, for example, we might be able to use it a second time, despite the fact that having done that in the first place, it's going to have already used it twice because of the Tarot Cloth, which is actually a really good item as well. So that shop, by the way, was a great shop, and it kind of justifies my having gone back for restock on the very first floor. Plus, we now have a trinket that will be giving us a blue HP to go on top of our black HP. Haggalaz really doesn't help us too much. So there you go, we smelted that. Oh, you lagged out. So when the bullets lag out, it's kind of destructive. But when the enemies lag out and get stuck, it's constructive. Which is weird. We now have Gimpy as well. So we've got to deal with the devil even though we didn't necessarily deserve it. Probably not going to spend the stuff on Demon Baby, even though we can get quite close to... enemies as a result of the fact that we're going to be invincible a lot. I don't think Demon Baby is the right call here. That could be a secret room, actually. We might not have had to pay for the curse room, even though we did. Not going in there. This is a dead end. Sorry? These enemies just keep stopping. It's very, very obscure. Use Haggalaz here because it's available. It's another one. And a golden heart. We might as well take this trinket. We're about to be able to smelt it. Which is going to turn every future red heart. It is a secret room as well. Into a demon heart, I believe. So much for having plenty of time. That was based on the fact that we weren't going to get stuck in this obnoxious dead end of lies. So there's all our demon hearts. We don't need red hearts. In fact, I wonder if that works with Gimpy. Yeah, Gimpy and little Chad. There's a black heart back for us. Nah. We ain't got time for this. Where the fuck is our boss? Oh my Jesus. There you are. Right. I mean, we might not make the hush fight simply because this boss was ridiculously far away for some reason. I love the fact that these things lag out and get out of sync. It's really weird. So now I guess we just walk into the boss and hope for the best. Not going to go and get that. Far too well gated. You lagged out. I'm loving this lag. Especially the way it sometimes shears the graphic. It's very laggy indeed. That's actually really entertaining. AWAS. I've got AWAS and answers. Oh, you've done what though?
Hagalaz.
AWAS and Hagalaz. Both of those are... Both of those are crawl spaces, but we didn't have time if you wanted to do the hush fight. Which is silly. At least we got our algae's rune. More trinkets, please. Two of hearts. Could be good. If we had something that hearts would do for us. We don't. More trinkets, please. I have the ability to make good use of them. Pick that up. Good. 90 cents means we can basically go nuts here. Blank hard algae's is a one game. And I am very tempted to just say... Heck it, I'm doing it. It's not very bizarre, but it entertains me, and that's what counts. Map, yes. This mystery gift. There's options, fair enough. Don't really need it. Wonder if there's options works for the next few... thingies. I wonder if Diplopia gives you a free item. It does. Okay, cool. We've got this. I don't want to take the, Oh, yeah, we should donate. I don't want to take the sharp plug because... Oh, brilliant. It's going to... I'm going to accidentally use it, basically. Can't really re-roll it. Give me the bombs that are great pain to myself. So we now blank card algae's a lot. Oh, I could have bought the battery and had two blank card algae's. Is this? Can't believe I got hit. I was too busy thinking about my mistake. The stopwatch actually helps here too. I'm not sure how much lag is going to help in this fight because, or indeed in the delirium fight, because I have a horrible suspicion that it's going to be pretty bad for us. I don't know where to stand in order to get Sack Dagger to do its job here. Because you see how it's causing these shots to, you know, pause? And it interrupts a pattern. Not that the pattern is that relevant normally anyway, because it's not that easy. Oh, come on, don't tell me that the I'm hiding underground animation also gets slowed down by stopwatch. Of course, algae's ran out. What? I kind of don't want to use algae's now. Because the lag is annoying. I might not get it back. Now, there's a chance we get it back anyway. It might be worth it. Just to ensure that we get through the hush fight in the first place. But, you know, with... Serpent's Kiss and More of the Void. Kind of expect to get some black hearts out of the waves. It's just, there's a fly there. We didn't pay for that damage, luckily. But you'd expect some of these to produce black hearts for us. But they ain't doing so. That's fine too. You know, you're not under any obligation to do so, except for the one where you are. The lag is weird, just go with it. Ah, fudge. Right. We've been unpaid for that as well, which is fine too. Ah, that's what we like to see. A little bit of profit. These shots, by the way, are not flies. Don't treat them as though they are. Daddy Longlegs is also doing some work by helping me out with the enemies the hut is currently spawning. I don't know how to deal with. Because they're miles away, actually. Perfect. Well, not actually perfect. I mean, I did the right thing, but it didn't actually pay off. Nearly got hit by that fly, but I did see it this time, so not so bad. Stay put. That's the trick to those. Find the safe place and stay in it. It's almost slightly easier to find the safe place when the shots are slower, but not actually as much easier to expect. So let's just do this while we've got the opportunity. The lag is behaving weirdly with these continuum shots, because normally you would expect to be able to follow them, but they seem to be doing this strange thing where it's well, not following them, basically. So somebody has produced a red heart, despite our trinket, that should have prevented that. It looks like it won't actually reach around. More innuendos? So we should be okay for this fight, but we didn't make as much of a profit as I was expecting to. Right, we're okay. We have succeeded. Not very well, but succeeded nevertheless. Let's go and buy 2 battery chargers. That should do it. We can't buy any black hearts or anything, and unfortunately there's no way of actually making good value out of these. What you should be doing is... yeah, that. There's a good chance of finding a crawl space down here. Spirit hearts, please. Okay, Dimble is basically a value add. Whenever our item is empty, we get a damage bonus, which means we smelt it. There we go. Now, we don't have the smelter anymore. I'd rather have blank card algaes and just chew through everything from now on. But, I mean, there aren't that many more trinkets I expect to get a huge amount of value from. The map, why do we have the compass? Did we buy the compass? Have I forgotten that we bought the compass? I guess we must have bought it whilst buying out various shops. Can you not do that? It doesn't really please me, being honest. I mean, we do have Serpent's Kiss, which is going to be giving us a lot more black hearts. We have the slowy down effects when we get hit, which will be helping us get black hearts. That enemy was illegally, I might add, walking across that chasm. We know where the secret rooms are. Very well. What did we do to deserve those? Unless we also got the blue map. In which case we should know, oh, Christ, everything about this. But I feel like I don't. Flank room. What?
Day guys
is fine. Blank room. It's doing both. So that's allergies and another blank rune. Yera. It's doubled all our blank runes. This could go on for a while. Because, of course, every single one of our... I didn't mean to do that. Every single one of our blank runes is going to become another blank rune. I think we got a lot of Yeras in there, basically. So, honestly, we can't lose. I see no method by which we can now lose, because we have sort of double charge on blank card, and a huge number of Algises that we could just use anyway, and the opportunity to drop another Algis if we do use it. So we should explode this. Super secret room could contain goodies. It's an extra hit, I guess. I don't want to accidentally fight Delerium. So I'm not going to go into this boss fight on account of how it fits the bill. Basically, Delerium can be in any boss fight where you could normally fit a large room, a 2x2 room, which this certainly you could, because it could be the top left corner of said room. So I think we just keep doing this. Hopefully we can get some value out of Serpent's Kiss. There you guys again. Fine. Ignore you lot. See you later, alligator. This one could also be Delerium. Again, don't really want to fight Delerium right now. Mostly because, although we have Algiers, I'd rather first of all have two blank card plays. This one up here cannot have a 2x2 room attached to it. In fact, have two blank cards available. Whoa! Oh, it does work down here. Guess we take the pills and hope that none of it is health up. Sunshine, health up, puberty. Two of those are invincibility, which we have better of. And the other two are health upgrades, because we've taken two puberty pills already, which means the third one is adulthood, which is a health up. It may also be a damage up, I don't know. I might as well just finish this room, because... yeah. Not even worth not doing. There we go. Fine. Let's go and find other bosses that we can beat. There's all our rooms. Can't go wrong. So this room up here can't be a... boss. It can't be a Delirium fight, so we'll do this boss. I would still like a Tears upgrade if it's all the same to you. A Yara rune, again. Not that useful. Not only do I want enough plays on my blank card Algiers, but I want to be able to take 12 hits of damage as well. So I'm hoping that that is going to be an option here. Of course, as soon as we get hit by Delirium in the first place, we're going to find ourselves slow. Full card does nothing for us. Puberty is bad for us. The trinket is probably going to cause too much confusion. So it's the sort of trinket you would replace when you found another trinket. But since there's a chance we don't find another trinket, and we've already smelted a bunch of good trinkets anyway, don't really need to do the... Woo, careful, big room. That actually exploded, even though it didn't need to. Walk into everything, kill it with fire. We also have the virus. What is causing us to do contact... double Bacano, and we get it back. What is causing us to do contact poison damage? More Bacano. Still no Guppy, by the way. More Bacano. I think because it uses it twice, that means we've got two opportunities for it to respawn, which means we've got a 1 in 4 chance that it doesn't give us one back. Basically. That explodes. I'm okay with it. We've got 2 speed, but I feel sluggish. Strange. But any of these could be... even this could be Delirium. Can we just go for it? Mask of Infamy. Not Delirium. Also fine. Great. You have to, even though Contract from Below could be good. At this stage, it's pretty much not. Because we don't need the consumables. There's nothing that Contract from Below can really give us right now that I'm excited about. Except for maybe twin golden chests that contain items. But they're not going to be chest items. We don't have Chaos. Ow. So, unless we bought it when I wasn't paying attention, which is entirely possible. There we go. We've got Vibrant Bulb and Dim Bulb. So, whenever we use our item, we get Dim Bulb benefit. And whenever it recharges, we get Vibrant Bulb benefit. But also, we have... we have the battery, so when we use our item, we actually don't lose Vibrant Bulb until the second time we use it. Blank Rune was AWAS and something. Algiers. Blank Rune is Bacano and another Blank Rune. Blank Rune is Hagalize and this is a Sun card, which we will just use because we don't really need it. And we'll keep our Algiers Rune and continue. It would be great to have Infestation 2 right now. I'm actually going to blow these up. We're not at full health, and that makes me sad. It's my own fault. It still makes me sad. Interesting. Chariot. Wheel of Fortune. Bacano. Blank Rune. Dagars and Algiers. Okay. I mean, this could give us some good stuff. Trinkets. Spirit Hearts. The crystal ball is not that great, actually, for us right now. Not a good trinket. Not good trinkets. Not a good trinket. Don't know what that trinket does. I'd like to be able to smelt them now, so that we can keep them. But... I can't. Boring. Let's go. Terrific. Whoa! Lag got me. I really like this lag item. The reason I like it is that it is currently working both ways. Fairly often it's working in my favor by stopping an enemy in its tracks and basically giving me the opportunity to beat the crap out of it at my leisure, at my lazure, eh? But then every so often it's holding a shot back that I was dodging and causing me to take the damage instead. I'm assuming the AWAS will open a trapdoor if it's gonna. So yeah, lag is a fairly well-balanced item simply because of the fact that it can cause you harm. That's good, because I was looking for a tinted rock and going, I can't be bothered looking for a tinted rock here. Delerium, no, lamp. Might as well use this. There are battery charges, so why not? So this has turned out to be a good introductory run, even though we had two false starts. I held up my finger so that you knew what a two was. I guess we take sticky bombs, because there's no point in taking a spacebar item right now. So there's two boss fights left. So I was right that one of those two boss fights is Delerium. Not intentionally right, but right nonetheless. We might as well just wend our way back down there. Interesting to learn that wend used to be the past tense of went. Which is why... the present tense of went. Which is why it seems obscure. That our language, the past tense of go, is went. But in fact, go is a new word. Wend is an old word. I wonder if the actual past tense of go would be goad. Depends where it comes from. I mean, it's gone, obviously. I really want scatter bombs. And having an extra 10 poison bombs is... not poison bombs, butt bombs. Going to be pretty nice. So this should be Delerium. So we'll start off by kicking some bombs in there. Good start. Well, you know, that's the way it goes. Let's just use our algaes once. And put ourselves here. We shouldn't really have needed to do that, but we have three goes on algaes at least. So there's almost no... Why are things exploding? Oh. Delerium does have explodey shots, but because everything's slow, we can't tell which one's which. This is unfortunate. So I think we're doing okay here. We should probably be using Sack Dagger as much as possible whilst we have the algaes up. And we can practice on... dodging and stuff. Look, lag. You're not helping. So lag is negatively useful in a bullet hell context. By and large. We already learned that on the hush fight, but, you know, I guess we're learning it again now. All the shots look the same, which is fairly difficult to... it's really difficult to follow. A lot of the shots are sticking, but not only sticking, but doing so in a... in a laggy way. So we've still got our... Why have you done this? Still got our allergies rune itself. I don't think we're going to need it, because this is basically game over for Delerium. But I thought that was game over for Delerium, because it did that weird thing. See, I'm not a fan of this this exit. This end. It seems a little cheap. They could have animated that better, in my opinion. I'm not saying I could have, but you know how it is. Have we seen this? I think we've seen this. We'll do that. Shade has appeared in the basement, so that is another achievement off the list. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. You know what to do. Leave a like, that helps our channel, and leave a subscribe, which helps you find our channel and go out and check out other people's content. I have an original Doom series, and James is doing Hollow Knight, and Ed is getting back in the game, so go and give Ed some love whilst he finds his YouTube voice, as we call it, which is like sea legs, but for talking. Anyway. Thank you for watching this extended episode of Failure, and I'll see you next time.